Hello everyone. In this video, I'll talk about mumps, which is a contagious viral infection that causes the swelling of one or more of the salivary glands, primarily affecting the parotid salivary glands. It is also known as viral parotitis. What causes mumps? Mumps is caused by Rubulavirus, which is RNA virus that is within the genus Paramyxovirus, and it is a member of the family Paramyxoviridae. It is also called the mumps virus. The virus is contracted by respiratory droplets and touching contaminated surfaces. The virus is excreted through salivary, nasal and urinary excretions. Children are most often affected, but adults can also contract the disease. Those at high risk of contracting viral parotitis include unvaccinated individuals, international tourists, pregnant women, living in overcrowded places, people living in epidemic areas. Now let's look at the clinical features of mumps. Mumps has an incubation period of 2 to 3 weeks. Patient is infective days before symptoms appear, and remains so 7 to 10 days after gland swelling reduces. Flu-like symptoms appear first, and they include fever, fatigue, lack of appetite, muscle pain. Parotid swelling may appear only on one side or both. Submandibular and sublingual salivary glands may also be enlarged. Following transmission of mumps virus, the virus resides in the nasopharynx and the salivary glands, causing it to enlarge. The swelling is tender on palpation. The diagnosis of mumps is usually clinical, except in cases where the parotid glands are not swollen. A physical examination of the facial swelling is required. Blood, urine, and saliva samples are taken to confirm the diagnosis. In severe cases, cerebrospinal fluid is tested to check if there is infection to the brain. Serum and urinary amylase, which are raised during the first week of parotitis. Serology. Serum IgG and IgM are measured as early as possible and after 10 to 14 days of illness. Presence of IgG indicates past exposure and possible immunity. However, rise in IgG titer more than 4 times from acute to convalescent serum indicates recent infection. Similarly, presence of IgM also indicates recent infection. IgM is present in 100% of the patients by day 5. If not treated, or if it is poorly managed, mumps can lead to the following complications: orchitis with painful and tender testes, oophoritis in girls and women, pancreatitis, aseptic meningitis or meningoencephalitis, which present with headache, neck stiffness and drowsiness. Unilateral sensorineural hearing loss can occur due to involvement of the labyrinth. Thyroiditis, myocarditis, nephritis, arthritis. The treatment of mumps is nonspecific. The conservative measures include taking enough fluids to keep hydrated, bed rest and cold or hot compresses over the parotid area to relieve pain. Analgesics and antipyretics can be prescribed. However, aspirin-containing medications should be avoided. Food which encourages salivary flow should be avoided, as they cause pain. These include acid foods, fruit juices, and spicy foods. Patients are advised to eat soft or liquid foods, as chewing may aggravate the pain. Most people recover from mumps within 2 weeks. The following measures can be taken to prevent mumps. Avoid sharing utensils and drinks. Cover your mouth when sneezing or coughing. Practice good hand hygiene practices. Clean and disinfect surfaces. Those who are sick should stay at home. An infant has maternal immunity for 1 year. After that, immunization can be given by MMR, that is, mumps, measles, rubella vaccine at the age of 15 months. Older children, adolescents and adults who are not protected by MMR and have not had mumps and are in contact with children should receive monoclonal mumps or MMR vaccine. Mumps immunoglobulin is of no value as a prophylaxis or in established disease. And that's all for this video. If this video has been helpful, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss out on our next upload. Thank you for watching. Until next time.